Now, I promised you that we would be interviewing some of the top artists on the show tonight, as well as some of the movers and shakers of the industry. Dancehall and reggae, that is. But my next guest in the studio, of course, has played an intricate role beyond reggae and dancehall. But he has dabbled in reggae and dancehall as well. Gil Green. Now listen, people. Those of you who are into production, those of you into top videos, knows exactly what I'm talking about. But for those of you who don't know who he is, he has made some of the biggest videos for the world to enjoy. Gil, pick up that mic and let's get into your business. Live from Best of the Best.
Yo, 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 yo.
The video maker, yeah. Gil Green, is in the building.
Yo, what's up? What an introduction.
Listen, man. Bar none, we've been fans of your work for years, right? And you have made some of our top artists even look bigger than life because of your productions, right? I know that there's some people that's listening to us right now and probably not familiar with who you are,
yeah,
but I'm sure they're familiar with your work. What are some of the videos that you worked on?
Lord, I mean, the first reggae video I did was SZA, Thank You Mama. And from there, it led to a slew of artists, Elephant Man, Ponda River, Juke Gyal, Get Low Remix with Elephant Man, Buju, Paid Not Played, Wayne Wonder, T.O.K., like all of the reggae greats. And even till today, like last year, we did Damian Marley, we did Sting and Shaggy. So for me, this is part of my passion. I grew up in Miami and around so many Yardies and spending summers in Jamaica. I just grew up with the culture. And so it's always been a part of me. So I was able to take the film and showcase the culture for so many years. I feel blessed to do what I love and be a part of this culture in some way, in some aspect.
Was it always something that you wanted to do, or did you just stumble upon making reggae videos?
Oh, no. This is a plan, man. Nothing just stumbles, man. I used to ask my teachers if I can scratch the book report and turn in video video movies as my report, and had an early audience from junior high school to high school to college. And you know, I feel blessed. Filmmaking and music is my passions, and when you put them together, you get music videos. So that's what I do.
You have taken a lot of our artists and really put them on the mainstream as far as videos are concerned. And what is the vibe that goes into the treatments that you make for, you know, how do you see our music that allows you to come up with those treatments?
Well, I think it's, for one, it's understanding and respecting the culture. Like, as someone who grew up in the sound clashes of Perrine and
wow,
seeing what was going down there in the late 80s and being able to apply that. So when I go to Elephant Man and we're doing Ponda River, I understand what dances he's calling out. You know, as a director, that's important. You can't just have a foreigner come in and then think like he's going to understand the culture. So for me, it's always been about culture. That's why I represent a lot of Miami artists, too. You know, I did Rick Ross's first video, DJ Khaled's first video, Flo Rida's videos, Pitbull's, you know, because I grew up in this Miami culture. So, for one, for me, it's always been about respecting the artists and the culture that they come from, because especially for dancehall and hip-hop, it's about representing a culture. So, that, I think, is the first part of anything. And then from there, it's the creativity. We have fun with it. We go everywhere with it.
Now, working with Jamaican artists, let's put it on the table, can sometimes be a headache. They show up late to the shoots, they do all kind of crazy things. We know how it goes.
Yeah.
Let's talk the truth, Gil.
Yo, that's with every artist.
That
goes for the Haitians and the African Americans and the Latinos as well, man. It's just,
so you just you're used to it by now. You just know what it is.
Yeah. You know what? I never really had that problem because I'm so invested that when I talk to the artist, I'm talking to them days before, and I let them know this is the schedule and this is all the things we're planning to do. So it's not like they just show up and they like, oh, what are we doing? They've known for a couple of days, like, yo, there's a team putting in a lot of effort for you right now.
Right.
So when I need Elephant Man at 6 o'clock in the morning, he was there at 5:30 practicing his dances in the camper. So that's how it is, man. And that's why we make great work, because they see the passion and people feed off passion. Passion feeds off passion.
Is there any artists, you know, reggae dancehall artists that you would like to do a video for or work with that you haven't done so far?
Man, there's so many I rate so highly.
Well, let's talk about that. Who are you listening to these days? Who are you admiring? Man,
I love Tyrus Riley, and me and him are working on a project right now.
Wicked.
Yeah, I love the positive vibes. So I love anyone that's like uplifting people, uplifting the youth, the youngsters, like teaching them a positive message. And then, you know, I love all the newest and the latest, but, you know, that comes around the plate. But some of the artists, like having the opportunity to work with Buju early and Sizzla and these type of artists that inspire. And it's not like the slackness is fun, too. But, you know, I like when there's a message behind it.
Listen, those of you just tuning in, we're talking to Gil Green. And trust me, he just gave you a list of videos that he has produced for dancehall and reggae artists. Some of you might want to take a look at some of those videos and you will appreciate why I'm having this conversation with him. Thank you so much for passing through the Soundshed tent, man. It's like, really, I feel honored for having you in the tent just because of what you've done. Thank you so much, man. Thank you so much.
Right. Before I'm out, I want to send a big shout out to the filmmakers in Jamaica that are doing it, because that's where the torch is being passed. You got Jay Wills, who's doing it. You got Storm. You got Ross Casa. So you have these really talented directors who now have the tools in the digital age. You know, before when we had to shoot on film, it was hard, or y'all say flim, it was hard to get that down there. But now these young directors and these very talented directors are taking it to the next level. So big up to all of them as well.
Yeah, man, thanks for spending the time with us, man. And again, keep up doing what you're doing. We're really, really proud of you, really championing what you're doing for us.
Nah, respect, man. Thank you for the t-shirt. I'm repping this all day, man.
Listen, another top person passing through the Soundchat 10 people. We are live at Best of the Best. Gil, don't go nowhere. We've got to take some pictures with you and the team, man, just to say that we saw you and we spoke to you. Turn up your radios loud.